Hello everyone, this is meteorologist Dave Snyder at the TV desk at the National Weather Service office in Anchorage, Alaska. We're monitoring a shift in the weather pattern that's headed for Alaska. It will bring significant impacts to many parts of our state, and we wanted to share what we're seeing with you so that you're better prepared. It's part of our mission to support Alaska in a weather-ready nation. First, let's look at what we consider to be a normal October jet stream pattern over Alaska. You'll recall that the jet stream is the fast-moving river of air at or about 30,000 feet that guides the major weather patterns around the planet. In a normal October, the jet is blowing more from west to east over the Bering and the Arctic, but we still have a connection to the subtropics. This allows remnants of western Pacific typhoons, along with substantial moisture, to move north and into southwest, south-central, and southeast Alaska. Notice how the jet is directed into southeast Alaska? For many along the Gulf Coast, especially southeast, it's the wettest time of year. As we look at next week, meteorologists see a pattern that looks more like this, a sharply defined trough or dip in the jet stream that changes the track of significant fall storms. This pattern still taps the subtropical moisture and storm energy from remnant typhoons, but the impacts will bring much warmer and wetter weather far into the interior and west coast of Alaska, while keeping active weather over south-central Alaska and slowing down the barrage of rain for southeast. This is very different. Here's what we expect to see with regard to temperatures. It's going to be unseasonably warm for all parts of Alaska. For places like Anchorage, and especially Fairbanks, that could mean temperatures running more than 10 degrees warmer both at night and by day. In Nome and Bethel, temperatures could run 5 to 10 degrees above normal. In Barrow, temperatures could hover close to freezing or above. Southeast could see temperatures 5 degrees above normal thanks to decreased precipitation. While the weather pattern is a major factor in producing this unusual heat, another consideration is that October temperatures are directly tied to the rapidly decreasing length of daylight hours in Alaska. Average temperatures usually fall off quickly in most areas this time of year, and that won't be the case next week. Here's the precipitation outlook. As I said, southeast is expected to be somewhat drier than normal, which is saying a lot during the wettest part of the season. With a subtropical moisture plume directed away from the panhandle, it may not be completely dry, but you should notice the difference. In south-central, places like Kodiak, the Kenai Peninsula, Prince William Sound, the Matsu Valley, and Anchorage could pick up that rainfall. Locally heavy precipitation may be possible in all of these areas. And along the west coast, frequent heavy rainstorms could bring 1 to 3 inches of rain to many places. Up to 4 inches could be possible in isolated cases. The mild temperatures are likely to preclude significant low-elevation snowfall for at least the next week, although small accumulations are possible on the backside of any passing storms, especially north of Kotzebue. Besides the warmth and rain, or less rain, what could it mean? Many places usually see their first snowfall, or accumulating snow, by mid-October. This weather pattern could delay any snow by more than a week. River and stream levels will remain elevated. And with saturated soils and increasing threats for high winds in the Alaska Range and South Central, tree and power line damage could be possible if high winds develop. And along the west coast, any passing storms could produce coastal storm surge and flooding. Remember, this is a broad look at a developing weather pattern 6 to 10 days in advance for the period from October 15th through 21st. This information is not meant to be specific, and you should continue to monitor forecast information from the National Weather Service offices in Anchorage, Fairbanks, and Juneau in the coming days for watches, warnings, and any advisories. You can do that by going to weather.gov on your computer or mobile device, using your NOAA weather radio, or tuning into the Alaska Weather Show every night, or watching or listening to your local TV or radio stations. Let us know what you think about this type of message in the comments section, and share it with your Alaska friends. This is National Weather Service meteorologist Dave Snyder, and thanks for watching.